Why do system cleanup utilities report so many errors on a supposedly clean system? Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got some time ago. I have a couple of good cleaning programs to protect my computer, which are usually recommended by you. But occasionally I get suckered into running a free trial of a program like a registry cleaner. I may have just run my cleaner and have been given a clean bill of health, but when I run the free trial, I invariably get hundreds of errors. Why? What you're experiencing is what leads me and many others to avoid recommending any registry or system cleaning utility. It's not that there are just a few bad apples that spoil the entire bunch. In this case, it's often really difficult to find an apple worth biting into at all. The most common reason a trial is going to report lots of errors is very simple. They want to scare you into purchasing their product to clean up what they supposedly found. Now, I say supposedly because the most disreputable scanners, and there are a lot of them, aren't above lying. They will report errors that don't exist. And of course, when you purchase the product, suddenly those errors disappear. It's not because of their exceptional error correction technology. It's because in reality, the utility did nothing at all. Many of the utilities that do clean things are still not above overstating the risk of what they find. For example, some may claim that having 1,000 cookies is a very serious performance and security risk. It's neither, and is nothing you need to act on. But if you buy into their rhetoric, you'll be convinced that you need to purchase their product to clean it all up, which they then do. Which brings up the second problem with cleaners. Ask 100 tech pundits about this topic, and you'll get 100 different opinions, maybe more. The same is true for creators of system cleaning software. Even among legitimate programs, a wide variety of opinions exist about what is and is not an error, what is and is not worthy of being cleaned, and what can and cannot be cleaned safely. The net result is that you could run one legitimate program to completion and have it report that your machine is now 100% clean, and then immediately run a different legitimate program, which might report that your machine's still riddled with cruft. There is no absolute measure of which of them is, quote-unquote, right. There just isn't a formal definition of what it means for a machine to be dirty. Oh, there are common things that most would consider dirt, but once you stray out of that list, things very quickly become unclear. And even on those items that everyone considers technically dirt, you'll find a variety of opinions about whether there's any value in cleaning it up. The biggest piece of advice I have is to resist the temptation to try the latest and greatest system cleanup utility or registry cleaner's free trial. Just don't. At a minimum, only run the tools you've heard of and that have a good recommendation from people you trust. If you've never heard of it, and the only words in support of it are from the tool's own site or their advertisements, walk away. The potential for harm or just wasting your time and money is just too great. Now, besides only using trusted tools, my honest single biggest piece of advice here is simply this. Don't try to fix problems you don't actually have. I ignore cleanup utilities entirely until I'm actually experiencing a problem. And only then will I consider using a utility, and even then I'm more likely to target the specific problem rather than use a more general purpose, fix everything kind of utility. As I said, there's lots of opinions on this. If you do elect to invest in a cleanup utility, I strongly suggest you do the research first to find out if it's worth what you're about to pay for it. And, of course, make sure to back up completely first before running any cleanup utility. You know, just in case. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4971. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.